method of expressing decimal as a fractional numbers. As you know, all in a decimal numbers, two types are there. One is a terminating decimal, one is a recurring decimal. First I will go for the terminating decimal. 0.1. I want to write this one as a fraction. See here, one upside as it is, and decimal means one. Then decimal afterwards, one digit is there, so then it will become a zero. 0.32. If I write this one, 32 by decimal means one, and two digits are there, so two zeros. I'll take one more example. 0.123. So I can write 1, 2, 3 divided by decimal means one, decimal afterwards 1, 2, 3, three digits are there, then three zeros. Some people, I think they may have the doubt, sir, how you are writing that? We can crash check also. Once I will do the crash checking here. 10, 1. See, 10 divisor is a 10, dividend is a 1. Then it won't go. So then I am keeping the decimal. So 10 ones are 10. See, 1 by 10 equals to 0.1. Same as like only here, I'll check for this 32 by 100. So 100 and 32. 32 it won't go because divisor is greater than dividend. So 100 zeros are 0. So downside 32. So then decimal here I can keep zero extra. Then 103 is 300. So 0 minus 0, 0, 2 minus 0 is 2. So now I can keep one more zero. So 100 2 is 200. I think now you got an idea about this. How I wrote decimal means 1. Means first we want to write that upside number as it is 32, and decimal means 1. Decimal afterwards, how many zeros are, how many digits are there? That many zeros. Here the two digits are there, so that's why I kept two zeros. I'll check for this also. So 1000 123 zeros are 1000 zeros are 0. So 123 as it is. Decimal I am keeping here the 0. 1000 ones are 1000. So 230, and I can keep one more 0. 1000 twos are 2000. 2000 300 minus 2000 becomes this 300. I can keep one more 0. 1000 threes are 3000. Same. If we convert this fraction, then we are getting this decimal. If we are converting this decimal, this fraction will come. Means vice versa. So this is regarding a terminating decimal. Terminating decimal everybody can do very easily. I'll give homework. See. 1.23, first one. 0.12345. these 5 questions you can do in your classwork. First one is 1.23 and 0.12345. Third one is 0.737, 0.02, 0.003. The next one is recurring decimals. Here for that I taken one example. Express 0.23 bar as a rational number. Means I want to represent this 0.23 bar as a fraction. So let's x equal to 0.23 bar I taken here. It means 0.23 23 23 as like a continuation. And by seeing here, we can take a periodicity. Periodicity is a 2, means the number of digits which are recurring. So the number of digits here, the 2 digits are recurring. So then we can say this one is a periodicity is a 2. So now I want to multiply this expression 1, means equation 1, by 100. Multiply equation 1 by 100 on both sides. So 100 into x equals to 100 into 0.23 23 23 as like go on. This one I am taking as a equation 2. Now it will become 100x. And when we are multiplying by the multiples of the 10, means here the 2 zeros are there, then the decimal place it will move the right side 2 digits. Means here 23.2323 as like go on. So you can take this one as a 3. Now I want to subtract equation 1 from the equation 3. So subtract equation 1 from equation 3. So equation 3 first I am writing, that is 100x equals to 23.2323 dash dash, and equation 1 is x, first one is x and 0. See, here we want to observe carefully decimal where it is there, that one we want to observe. So decimal downside I wrote the decimal, and decimal before one digit is there, so that is a 0. So afterwards see 2 2 3 2 3 continuation. Now and to do what I want to do, subtract. So 3 minus 0, 3 minus 3 is a 0, 2 minus 2 is a 0, 3 minus 3 is a 0, 2 minus 2 is a 0, decimal as it is, 3 minus 0 is a 3 and this is a 2, and equals to here 100x minus x means 99x. So now x equals to 23 by 99. This is a answer. We can go for the shortcut also. The next one is recurring decimals. Here for that I taken one example. Express 0.23 bar as a rational number. Means I want to represent this 0.23 bar as a fraction. So let's x equal to 0.23 bar I taken here. It means 0.23 23 23 as like a continuation. And by seeing here, we can take a periodicity. Periodicity is a 2, means the number of digits which are recurring. So the number of digits, here the 2 digits are recurring. So then we can say this one is a periodicity is a 2. So now I want to multiply this expression 1, means equation 1, by 100. Multiply equation 1 by 100 on both sides. So 100 into x equals to 100 into 0.232323 as like go on. This one I am taking as a equation 2. Now it will become 100x, and when we are multiplying by the multiples of the 10, means here the 2 zeros are there, then the decimal place it will move the right side 2 digits, means here 23.2323 as like go on. So you can take this one as a 3. Now I want to subtract equation 1 from the equation 3. So subtract equation 1 from equation 3. So equation 3 first I am writing, that is 100x equals to 23.2323 dash dash, and equation 1 is x, first one is x, and 0. See, here we want to observe carefully, decimal weight is there, that one we want to observe. So decimal downside, I wrote the decimal, and decimal before one digit is there, so that is a 0. So afterwards, see 2, 2, 3, 2, 3 continuation. Now and what I want to do, subtract. So 3 minus 0, 3 minus 3 is a 0, 2 minus 2 is a 0, 3 minus 3 is a 0, 2 minus 2 is a 0, decimal as it is, 3 minus 0 is a 3, and this is a 2, and equals to here 100x minus x means 99x. So now x equals to 23 by 99. This is a answer. We can do this problem in a shortcut. See, x equals to 0.23 bar. So what I am going to do, once observe here, write all the digits upside, means 0, 2, 3, and minus. The digits are not recurring, means here the not recurring one is only 0, because 2, 3 is recurring. And the downside, the digits, number of the digits which are recurring, that many nines. See here the 1 and 2, means 2 digits are recurring, the 2 digits are, instead of the 2 digits, you want to write the 9s. Then answer is 23 minus 0 by 99. So answer is 23 by 99. This is one technique. Once observe here, express a 12.05 bar as a rational number. Here express a 12.05 whole bar, means here the bar is for the 2 digits, here bar is for the single digit. We'll write according to the our shortcut. Total digits 1205 minus the digits which not have the bar, all the digits you should write. And the downside, how many digits having the bar, that many zeros, that many nines. So here the one digit have the bar, so that's why I kept 19. And after the decimal and the digits are not having the bar, that many zeros. So here 10. So 5 minus. ₹1,085 by 90. And we can cancel. So 5 table I am using. 5 2's a 10, 5 1's a 5, 3 remains. 5 7's a 35. And here also 5 1's a 5, 4 remains. 5 8's a. Answer 217 by 80. If we go for here, the same. First you should write all the digits. Minus. The digits are not having the bar. Means here 192, the digits not have the bar. Divided by. And how many digits are having the bar, that many nines. See, here the two digits have the bar. So, two nines. And after the decimal, the digits are not having the bar. See here, after the decimal, there is a no digit not having the bar. Because here the two digits it have the bar. So no need to keep the zero. Now, 5 minus 2 is a 3. 10, 10 minus 1 is a 9. 1, 1. 99. I think now you got an idea about the problem. In the textbook, they given a answer for, means for this question, they given this answer. Thing is that you want to change their bar for the two digits. Another principle also we can use here, that recurring decimal equal to the whole number obtained by writing the digits in order. The whole number obtained by writing the digits in order minus the whole number made by the non-recurring digits in the order and divided by 10 to the power the number of the digits after the decimal point minus 10 to the power the number of the digits after the decimal point do not recur. You can use this principle also. I'll take one example. What we done previously, that I am writing for this number. See, here the total digits minus and the whole number made by the non-recurring digits. Non-recurring means this part. By 10 to the power, the number of the digits after the decimal point. Number of the digits after the decimal point 2 minus 10 to the power. The number of the digits after the decimal point do not recur. Do not recur means here no point, no digit is there because all are recurring. So now I can write by 100 minus 10 to the power 1. 10 to the power 0 value is 1. So answer is 3, 9, 1, 1 by 99. This is another method. Find the value of 0.424242, that's just continuation, means it's a recurring decimal, minus 0.353535, it's a dash dash, means a continuation, it's a recurring decimal. By seeing this problem, some people they may think they can do direct subtraction, So which is a wrong one? See, first I am going to say that wrong method. So many people, they will think they can do subtraction as like they may thought. See here, so 12 minus 5 is a 7, 3 minus 3 is a 0, here it is a 12, so 7, 0, here it is a 12, 7, 0, it's a continuation. But this method is a wrong method. How we want to do? I'll show in what way we want to do. See, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, continuation. Continuation. I can write this one as 0.42 bar minus 0.35 bar. Now I can write in the form of the P by Q. So total digits, that's 042 means 42 minus which are not recurring decimal before here the 0 is there, 0. And the digits which having the bar, that many nines, here the two digits having the bar, so two nines, and the decimal before the decimal afterwards the zero not having the bar, here no digit is there. So next one is 035 minus decimal means that the digits not recurred, so that is only zero, and number of the digits having the bar, so here the two digits having the bar, so two nines, and after the decimal number of the digits not having the bar, so here after the decimal two digits are there, the two digits having the bar, so this much only. So 42 minus 0, 42 by 99, this is 35 by 99. So denominator is 99, so both are the same, so I can write 42 minus 35, so it's 7 by 99, it's the correct answer. So don't go for this method. Some may raise the question also as like, sir, here you got the this 070707 as like continuation, here after doing the decimal, for only this problem you will get the same, but remaining all the problems you will get the different, but unfortunately this problem you will get the same answer. But this method is correct. Only you want to, after converting into the P by Q form, then only you can do subtraction or addition, because it is a continuation, there is a no end. For the no end one, you cannot do subtraction. Which is a end one or which is a terminal, means which have fixed value, for that only you can do the addition or subtraction. So remember this point. The homework problem, first question is 0.123 bar, second one is 0.123 bar, third one is 0.123 bar, total bar, fourth one is 1.235 bar, and fifth one is 1.0101 dash dash continuation. Convert these all the problems into the form of the P by Q, otherwise we can call express as a rational numbers. Next property is a closure property. If x comma y belongs to P and x operation, here the star means operation, x operation y belongs to P, then we say P is closed under the operation, that is star. Star means we can use the operation plus minus into division. We'll take some example. Suppose 1 plus 2 equal to 3, otherwise half plus half equals to 1. Think that P is a real number, so half is a real number and half is a real number, and sum of this 2 is also a real number. If I take 1 minus 2 equals to minus 1, here 1 is a real number and 2 is also a real number. In a subtraction, the result minus 1 is also a real number. See, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 equals to 0. 1 by 2 is a real number and minus 1 by 2, that result is a 0. 6 into 1 by 2 equals to, that's a 6 by 2, that leads 3. Here 6 is a real number and 1 by 2 is a real number. The product of this 2, 3 is also a real number. If we take one more example, 1 divided by 2 equals to, that is 1 by 2. In a closure property, generally for the whole numbers, natural numbers, integers, when we go for the division, that time it won't satisfy. But here it is satisfied, because in a real numbers all the fractions also exist. 1 divided by 2, that is 1 by 2. 1 by 2, see, 1 is a real number, 2 is a real number, 1 by 2 is also a real number. So commonly we can say as like x operation y belongs to P, then we say P is the closed under the operation. Suppose here these are closed under the addition, here these are closed under the subtraction, here these are closed under the multiplication, here these are closed under the division. In a division, only one case is an exceptional one. When the denominator is 0, then it is not possible. Already I explained about the 0 property previously, except for 0.